Hey guys, this is Chris Super here. Lovely to see you all again. And in this lesson, we're going to be looking at Kirk and James's solo in Suicide and Redemption by Metallica. It is an absolute doozy. Let's take a look. Alright guys, let's take a look at the first section. We're going to start off with this phrase. Let's slow that down. I'm playing 4-5-4 open on the third string as a hammer-on into a legato roll. I'm doing that all in one motion. At the end of that, I'm doing a pull-off from 4 to open on the fourth string. At the end of that, I hit 4 of the third string three times and I'm going to slide it up on the third. Then I work into this phrase. Let's slow that down. I'm going to hit 12 of the second string twice, jump back to 10, and then play 12 of the third string. And I've got a similar phrase. I'm just going to chuck a 13 at the front. So I'm going to play 13, 12, 10 on the second string, and then jump to 10 of the 12 of the third. So back to back, we'll have this. At the end of that, I'm going to hit the 12 twice and then do a cheeky open note. That's more of a transition thing than just sort of a melodic idea. That'll get us back for the repeat of that idea. So this is what we should have thus far from the top. Then when I go back to this idea again, instead of doing the legato, I'm going to play pretty much the same melody, but I'm going to go. So instead of hammering on into a pull-off and then going backwards, I'm actually going to bend up a semitone, then back, and then pull off. So the melody's the same, I'm just kind of accentuating it differently with a different technique. The rest of that phrase is identical. So if I play them back to back, you'll see that they're both exactly the same. After I do that, I work into this phrase. Now, this is kind of similar to the previous section, but I'm going to start with a different starting note. So I've got this. Let's slow that down. I'm going to start from 14 of the second string. It goes 14, 12, 10 on the second, then 12 of the third. Then I play the same phrase that we had before from 13, which was 13, 12, 10, and then 10 of the third string all together. And after that, I'm going to slide backwards. We work into that kind of tremmy bit after that, which is this. And that'll get us through the whole first section. So let's have a look at that idea. I'm working through two B octaves. I'm playing the second fret of the fifth string. I'm going to do an eighth note followed by four 16th notes, or if you're a British descent, we'll be looking at a quaver into four semi-quavers. So I'm going to go 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that other octave I had of that B note was on 9 of the fourth string. So we're going. Does that idea twice. At the end of the second group, I'm going to hammer on from 9 to 10 on the fourth string and then hit the 9 again. After that, I'm going to work in groups of four 16th notes or four semi-quavers on each of these notes, building up that scale. Let's go through those notes a little bit slower. I'm going to play 9 on the 4th string 4 times, then to 10. Then I play 7, 9 on the 3rd with 4 notes each. And then the last string, I'm from the second string, I'm gonna have four notes in a row. I'm gonna go 7, 8, 10, 11. With the four 16th notes on each, we're gonna have this. And then that'll lead us into the second section. So let's go from the little tremmy bit and then we'll take it right back to the start. So we've got. Let's go right back to the start of the section, play it again at a gentleman's pace, and then we'll do it again even slower with some tabs. One more time with some tabs. Alright guys, let's have a look at the second section. I'm going to start from 12th fret of the second string and we're going to have this phrase. Let's slow that down. What I'm going to do at the beginning is have a group of eight and then a single note afterwards, so you can think of it as nine notes. I'm going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, going from 16th notes into what I believe is an eighth note. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And at the end of that, I'm jumping to the third string and I'm playing 11, 9, 12, 11. At the end of that, I'm gonna play 9, 11, 11. So all together, hopefully that's making sense. And then we're gonna start off the same way. So I'm gonna play the nine notes on 12 of the second string. And then I want to play 9, 12, 11 again. Then I'm going to repeat 9, 12, 11 again. So that's the difference, is we're going to go. The only difference is at the end of the second group of that, I'm going to have that extra 11. So I'm going to play both of those ideas back to back and then we'll work into the next chunk. Hopefully that's all making sense. Then I work into this phrase. What I've got here is a bend from 14, then 17, then 9 on the third string, and they're all whole steps. I'm gonna bring it down, and then do a hammer-on pull-off from 7 to 9 back to 7. Then I work into this next phrase, which is pretty cool. Okay, let's slow that down. I'm going from a G note here, which is fret 3 of the first string. And then I'm going to hammer on, pull off 2, 3, 2 open on the first string. Then I go to 3 of the second string, so a bit slower. At the end of that, I'm going to play 2 open on the first string and then 3, 2 on the second. All together. Then I work into this triplet phrase. Let's slow that down. I'm gonna play 5-3-2 twice on the second string with that triplet pulse, obviously, and then the 3-2 open twice with the triplet pulse. All together. That's all of the second section of James's solo. So let's go right back to the start of the section, do it again at a gentleman's pace, and then we'll do it again even slower with some tabs. One more time with some tabs. All right right, guys, last section of James's solo. It's relatively short. I'm gonna start from two of the third. And I'm gonna slide that over from two to four. Then I'm gonna slide from four to seven, then back from seven to four. So we're gonna go. Then I wanna hit the four again when I return. So all together. At the end of that. I'm gonna do a hammer-on from four to seven on the third string, and then I'm gonna do a hammer-on pull-off from four to seven back to four on the third string. So it goes all together. At the end of that, I'm gonna play six at the third string. And then after I've hit that three times, so I've got a single, one, two. So after I've done the single and then the two extra, I slide over to seven. I'm gonna do one more hit on seven, and then that drags us up to that high area where we can do that final fill. So let's have a look at what we've got thus far. After that, I work into this phrase. It's such a Kirk Hammett-ism of a lick, and it's interesting to know that James is playing that. I think it's really cool. So what I've got here is I'm playing 22 of the first string, pulling off to 19 of the first, and then jumping to 22 of the second. So we've got, and that's our group of four. So I'll be returning to that 19 on the first string. That phrase is gonna repeat four times. At the end of that, I'm just gonna slide backwards from that 22, and that's when we tag in to be Wah Wah Kirk. That is all of the third chunk of James's solo. Let's put that together at a gentleman's pace, and then we'll do it again even slower with some tabs. One more time with some tabs. Alright guys, let's have a look at Kirk's solo now. We're going to be starting off with this phrase. So kind of all around the F sharp minor pentatonic, I'm going to start off with this kind of double stop bend idea. I'm playing five of the second string, four of the third with the bend. Then I've got, I'm going to bend four up and back as a single note, then play two of the third into four of the fourth. Then I kind of reverse my steps. So I'm going to play four of the fourth string, two, four on the third string. Then I work into this phrase. So I'm bending those double stops together, which is four of the second and four of the third. There's going to be three of those all together. So we've got. After the third bend, I'm going to play two of the third string into four of the fourth. Then from that point, I'm going to play that double stop here on the second and third string three times. So we've got, after I hit the double stop three times, I jump to four of the third string. Then from that point, I'm going to play four of the fourth string and then two, four on the third string. And that's going to give us this. So let's try that whole thing from the start now. From the bend, and then we're going to repeat pretty much the same idea again with a slightly different ending. So we've got. So all the way up to here, that double stop three times is going to be the same. So I'll show what we're dealing with. Exactly the same to that point, and then I go. That's all that's changing is that little cheeky lick at the end. I'm gonna be playing four of the fourth string twice. And I've got a quick hammer on pull off going 2-4-2 on the fourth, on the third string. And then resolving to four of the fourth. So I've got, and that'll set us up for that phrase that follows. Obviously you can tell I am playing this without wah now. It is just a little bit easier to teach you guys as the notes are non-wah'd and you can add it yourselves later. So I'm going to play the whole thing again from the top at a gentleman's pace. Obviously, it's going to be the same thing twice with the different ends, and then we'll do it again even slower with some tabs. Here we go. One more time with some tabs. Alright guys, second section. This is going to take place around the F-sharp minor pentatonic again. We're going to start off with this phrase. I'm going to be playing two of the first string, five of the second, and then a bend on four of the third. I've jumped to two of the third there, then four of the fourth, and we're going to have this. At the end of that, I'm going to play two of the third string, a bend from four, then back to the two. At the end of that, just working up the pentatonic from four of the fourth string. At the end of that, 2-4 on the third. So all together we're going to have this. Hopefully that's making sense. Then I'm going to borrow this phrase. So that phrase is going to actually reoccur exactly the same three times. You can see there's a couple of similarities that are occurring. So the second group's gonna have this. At the end of that, you notice that I'm getting that cheeky flat five in there. So what I'm doing here is I'm playing two of the third and then 5-4-2. At the end of that, building through the scale from four of the fourth and then 2-4 of the third. So we've got. Now the third group is going to be very similar to that in that I'm borrowing all the way through to that flat five lick. It's just got a different end. So after I've gone backwards here, at the end of that, I'm playing four of the fourth into two of the third, and that does a bend into a pull off from fourth fret of the third string. So all together. Let's have a look at the whole thing thus far, and then we'll add the end to it. So we've got. Hopefully that's making sense. Then I work into this phrase. What I've got here is one phrase four times and another phrase twice. So the phrase that I'm repeating four times, I've got a bend into a pull off from two, what was that? Four of the third into two of the third, bending in and out into that pull off, and then I'm jumping to four of the fourth. And I'm gonna repeat that four times. One, two, three, four. And then at the end of that, I've just got two of the bend into a pull off. And so if we put that all together, hopefully that's all making sense. So if we put that all together from the start, that will be all of section five, or the second chunk of Kirk's solo. So let's put it together at a gentleman's pace, and then we'll do it again even slower with some tabs. One more time with some tabs. Okay guys, last section. This isn't too long, but there are a lot of notes in it. Luckily, we're dealing with some pretty predictable hammertisms, if you could call them that. So we're gonna start off with this phrase. So what I'm doing there is I'm working just a F sharp minor pentatonic lick, simple legato ideas. The way I think of it is I've got a four note grouping and then two six note groupings, and then I repeat that again. So the four note grouping is gonna be this. I've got a pull off from four to two on the third string, and then I jump to four of the fourth and then back to two of the third again. And that's going to be my 1, 2, 3, 4. That's my 4-note grouping. Now my 6-note grouping is going to be the same idea, but I've got 2 pull-offs at the start. So I'm going to go. So all together, I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm going 4, 6, 6, and then I repeat that on the second bar of this group as well. Hopefully that's making sense. I'll do it one more time a bit slower. Then from that point, I've got the 4-note grouping idea working chromatically up for 8 groups. So I've got. Now I don't know whether it's exactly 1 fret at a time. He's just kind of moving it as he goes. The way that I think about it as I'm doing is I'll start that phrase from 5 of the 3rd string and I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I should be getting from 5 to 12, and then if I repeat that phrase, pull off, jump up a string, and then back to the pointer, 1, 2, 3, 4. If I repeat that 4-note phrase 8 times with that chromatic ascend, I should be finishing on 12. Okay, hopefully that's making sense. At the end of that, it goes into that really nice, whatever that riff is, straight afterwards. What I have here is 17 of the second and 17 of the first together, but I'm going to bend that second string. I would recommend not rushing it on the way down. Build the tension, enjoy the deliciousness that is that bend. And that is all of the final section of the solo. I'm going to play it again at a gentleman's pace, and then we'll do it again even slower with some tabs. One more time with some tabs. And those were the solos from Suicide and Redemption by Metallica. I hope you guys enjoyed the lesson. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. And if you want access to the tabs for this lesson and you want to hear any extra going-onings of Chris Zupa's life, you can join up with the mailing list. All of the cool kids are there if they want extra content. Also have multiple books out at the moment if you want to check them out. My most recent being Drop Tune Guitar Riff Writing. I have multiple books on improvisation and scale work and all of those kind of fun things. And they are all also available in video course format on Udemy, chriszupa.com, and recently I've started putting some content up on Skillshare as well if you want to check that out. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the lesson. I'll catch you all very soon. Take care.